I want to show you a quick example of something, and you try to figure out how I got this to work. I'm going to do File New. I'm going to build a new ProcessBook display. And look at this. Here's a script that gets involved and says what color background do you want to make it. I think I'll choose blue. There we go. There's a ProcessBook display that now has a blue background. How did I get access to that application event? Well, that seems simple enough. Let me show you what you might think off the top of your head. So, of course, this is what I thought the first time I used it, and I was wrong. I thought, well, this is not a problem. Just go into the editor here, and let's look for the application object and get access to its events. And then, of course, I look here, and I say, well, there's no application object there. I look in the properties window. There's no application object there. How do you get to the application object? And then I thought some more, and I said, well, hold on a second. This is a display, and if I were to add another one, that would be another display. Here's another display. Let's go back to the Visual Basic Editor. These are two different displays. How can there be an application object that represents the entire application when basically our code is being written in the display, not in the application? How can you get an object that is at a higher level than the place where we're working right now, which is actually the code? Well, the way you do that is you go to the application object using a variable that's defined with events. See, I can build a process book. I can add a process book, and I can look at that process book in the immediate window. You know, I can do that right now. I can say, let's print out the application dot procbooks count. This tells me currently there are zero process books open. And if I were to open a PIW file, I would find some process books. I can go into the displays collection. I can say how many displays are there open. There's two displays. But how do we get to this object itself, to the application object, and get to its properties or its procedures? Well, for that you need to dimension with events. And if I can demonstrate briefly, I'll just say let's dimension x. I got the syntax wrong. Dimension with events x as ProcessBook object library application. And at this point I now have an object that has all those events that are associated with the application itself. That's how we get to the application object. It has very important ramifications when it comes to doing add-ins, because with add-ins we generally need to get to the application object. Now that we know about using with events and application objects, let's take a look at that last example. This was an example called app event, and if we look at its code, as you can see in the general declarations, what we're stating here, this is where we define our variables. What we're stating is we're dimensioning with events. It's a variable called my class object var. And of course I could have defined that as x. That's not a meaningful word, that's just a name. My class object var is defined as a process book application. Now that gives us events that are associated with that object variable. The next thing I have to do is I have to somehow associate my class object var with my current application. Now for this, I'm using something called the display open method. It's the first time we've seen this. There is a display object in ProcessBook, that's the current display, and that object has an open method. The open method is what happens, or the open, excuse me, event. The open event is what happens when you first open a display. When this display opens, I'm going to use the set command to set a reference in this variable to the ProcessBook object library. In other words, this we're basically returning a dispatch interface into this object library, or excuse me, to the object library of the ProcessBook application. So my class object var, in other words, has been made a pointer to that object right there. Now because that object, or this variable, is defined with events, that means that we will pick up all the events that are associated with that application. This is a very important step, because without this, well, basically you have a variable but it's not pointing to anything. Microsoft likens this to a cookie cutter. When you dimension a variable, like we did back here, dimensioning a variable is like saying I'm going to have an object that is a certain type. Well, you don't actually stamp the cookie until you use the set command. That actually creates the instance of the object. So this creates a pointer of a certain class of object. It's pointing to that particular object. Now, since we are using with events, the events do show up in this list for my class object var, and here's the event that I got interfered with. This is the new display event. If you recall, when I built a new display, we had a little prompt. This was an input box that said what background color did you want, and of course at that point I just changed the background color. The new display object actually returns, or the new display event returns, a variable called a new display, which is it's a pointer to the display that is being created. So this is how we get access to the application events.